line here.
Yeah.
Okay, we're filming.
Just being a neighbor.
tribute of respect to our friend and loved ones, Harry and Bonnie Vincent. We want to first of all let you know that you're welcome. There's a few seats up here, and we're all family and friends, so you can gather in. We didn't anticipate this big of a crowd, but I know one thing about Harry and Bonnie, and that's that they wouldn't have wanted a super formal funeral. And so even though some of us are dressed up today, we want all of you to feel at home among the family that's gathered and the friends. And we're here to honor the memory of Harry and Bonnie, and we're also here to worship the Lord as we share the faith that they had. And we're so happy that we can have this here in our home church. So today we're gathered to indeed pay our final respect and love to Harry and Bonnie Vincent. To you members of the family, Clint, Andy, Christine, Jean and Carol, Tara, Christine, we offer you our deepest sympathies. May we share with you the comfort afforded by God's word for such a time as this. Jesus said in the Gospel of John, chapter 11, verse 25 and 26, the Lord himself said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. And also our Lord said in John chapter 14, he said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. So let's open in prayer today. Father, we thank you for those that have gathered here. And Lord, we pray that we would honor the memory of Harry and Bonnie. But also, Father, as we mindfully think about our own mortality and that of Harry and Bonnie passing on, Lord, that our worship to you would be acceptable today. We come to this funeral service for Harry and Bonnie in sincere dependence upon you. And you are the one in whose name we're gathered together today. We know that you love us, and you can turn the valley of the shadow of death into the dawn of the morning light. Help us now to wait before you with submissive hearts. Father, you are our refuge and strength, a very present help in time of trouble. Grant us your abundant mercy today. May those who mourn find comfort and healing in the grace that is ours because of the sacrifice of yours at the cross. So we humbly ask these things in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Just a couple announcements before we continue on. We want you to know that you're welcome for a potluck lunch reception in our fellowship room after the service. And it's just over here to my right, your left, after the service. You can also go the back way past the restrooms to get there and hang a right in the hallway. If you haven't signed the guest book for Harry and Bonnie yet, we encourage you to do so and leave a memory that you can share that the family will be able to look over that in the coming weeks and months and remember your memory along with their own. So please know those things. At this time, I'd like to ask Pastor Victor Berg and his wonderful wife, Johnette, are going to lead us in song with the old rugged cross as well as It Is Well With My Soul.
Yeah. this opportunity of rejoicing because Jesus has made the way for us. We don't have to miss heaven. We can make it our way. And then we can see whatever the trials and problems that come our way, it is well.
Vincent Jr. and Bonnie Lee Vincent. Harry passed away in his home on July 27, 2014, and Bonnie Lee passed away at home on August 1, 2014, and followed him to heaven. After 57 years of marriage, they left this world together, both following illnesses. Harry was born in Manhattan on March 7, 1937, to Harry Sr. and Montana Reynolds Vincent. Shortly thereafter, they moved to Willow Creek, where he attended school. He then attended and graduated from Three Forks High. He enlisted in the Army Reserve at the age of 15 and was honorably discharged on October 8, 1962. He was employed by JC Penney and then Morrison and Mairele of Helena. He then took up the trade of drywall and hung sheetrock in the Helena area and around the state for 37 years, belonging to the Carpenters Union for that full time. Lastly, working for Greenway Enterprises until he retired, receiving the Golden Hammer Award and the 3,000 Accident Free Hours Award. Never late for anything in his life. Harry was generally at work making coffee before anyone else arrived. He loved to tinker in his shop and always worked on some project or another. He loved to fish with his great-grandsons. Bonnie was born in Great Falls on August 4, 1939 to Claude and Josie Knapstead Tannehill. She attended schools in the Canyon Creek and Dearborn areas and in Montana City and here in Helena. She was very proud to receive her GED in Helena on March 7, 1973, which was Harry's birthday, at the age of 35. She was employed by Eddie's Bakery early in her life, and after having children, she was a stay-at-home mom, keeping the home fires burning when Harry was working out of town. Later, she started her own home cleaning business, which she ran for many years. She then worked at the Shelby House in Helena as a cook and caregiver. She was a very well-known coupon lady in Helena in 1982 when she walked out of the grocery store with two shopping carts piled high and $140 in free groceries.
Yeah.
And Clint tells me that was a lot in 1982. She was also the Tops takeoff pound sensibly runner-up queen for Montana in 1983. In July of 94, she was elected the Democratic precinct chairwoman for Precinct 34.
Yeah.
Both mom and dad were avid bowlers and roller skaters in their younger years, and they were married on August 24, 1957 in this church, the Helena First Church of the Nazarene, but not at this location. They spent 57 years in marriage. And you know, Clint and I and Harry and Bonnie and Christine and Andy knew that they were both in their last days, I remember telling Harry how well he'd done, that he kept those vows. And Harry cried as he thought about it. But isn't that awesome? 57 years of marriage. Mom never had a bad word to say about anyone. She would always see the good in others. They spent their years helping anyone who needed a hand, taking people into their home who had nowhere else to go. Mom spent hours in the kitchen cooking for family and friends and carrying on the tradition of candy and treat making at Christmas. Dad would loan a car or a hand to anyone. Dad loved the children and spent many hours entertaining them at family functions. They're survived by many loved ones, family, and friends. Their three children, Clint and Tara Vincent, Christine McCullough, and Andrew Vincent, all of Helena. Bonnie's sister, Claudia, and Jim Buxton of Everett, Washington. Harry's brothers and sisters, Gene and Carol Vincent of Butte. I lost my place. Trudy and Dave Miller of Townsend. Reven Dean Weisbeck of Denver and Darlene Dawson of Shreveport, Louisiana. Numerous grandchildren, great-grandchildren, cousins, uncles, aunts, nieces, and nephews. Harry and Bonnie were both followers of the Lord Jesus Christ, and they gave selflessly of themselves in all spheres of life, including here at their home church, Helena Nazarene Church. They will be missed, but always remembered with fondness and love. And the scripture that came to mind as I thought about him is from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7 through 8. And Paul wrote this, but I can speak it of Harry and Bonnie as well. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all. To all who have loved his appearing. So, Father, we thank you for a life well lived, for a wife and a husband who loved one another, for a mom and a dad, a grandparent and a grandma and a grandpa who loved their kids and who served. So, Father, we honor you, Lord Jesus, for the life that you've given and the life that you've taken away. and the life that on that great resurrection day we'll see again. At this time, Christine is going to read The Burning Eyes of God. It's in your funeral folder, but this was written by Bonnie herself, and it's beautiful. Do you want to come up front, or do you just want to read it right here? Either's okay.
The Burning Eyes of God. Early one morning, before the break of day, on my knees I knelt to pray. I asked my Heavenly Father to keep my eyes on Jesus and not the world around me. As I knelt there, a pathway did appear. It led upward, straight and narrow. Like mother of pearl, it glowed with a light of its own. Up through the darkness it went, to a heavenly throne. There above the clouds it stood uniquely, carved out of ivory whiter than snow. Superimposed on the throne, glowing like hot coals, but softened with a compassionate love, were the burning eyes of God, looking deeply into my soul. As I knelt there feeling very humble and small, I prayed that he saw inside, what he saw inside was pleasing in his sight. I praise and thank you, Lord, for a small glimpse of the glory that is yet to come in the burning eyes of God. Written by Bonnie Vincent.
I think at this time we have a couple videos, don't we? The first is Skydive by Harry and Clint, and the second one will be Memorial and Pictures. Okay.
I said, well, why can't you see this sucker? Good job, David.
What?
You too, Mike. I'm going to hand you these yellow things, too.
Here too, y'all.